Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to be talking about the transport analogies as it relates to transport of electric charges. The analogies for heat, mass, and momentum transfer videos are available in the description below if you're interested. The purpose of these analogies is to demonstrate how electric charge, mass, heat, and momentum transfer are all mathematically analogous. So, let's begin by stating a general rate equation. So the rate that something occurs is the driving force over the resistance against it. So really think about this though. Think of the driving force like the amount of water flowing through this pipe here. With little to no resistance and a very high driving force, it seems pretty obvious that the water will come out of this outlet at a very high flow rate. However, if we place some resistance, like more pipe friction or something to impede the water's flow, it will greatly decrease the rate at which the water comes out of the pipe. Let's find out how we relate the rate of current flow to the rate of transport analogy. So, let's begin by developing Ohm's law, and then work from there. So, to find Ohm's law, we need to start with the flow of electric charge in a piece of metal. The current flux, also known as the current density, the amperes per meter squared, is the amount of charge flow per area. This is equal to the electric conductivity times the voltage in all Cartesian directions. So, we would represent this by the following equation. However, the del or nabla term here is often used as shorthand to make your equations look much cleaner. For simplicity, let's only assume that our electrons can only flow in one direction. Because of this, the change in voltage over our change in the x direction is simply going to equal the change in voltage over the length. Lastly, we achieve the famous Ohm's law equation by recognizing that the electrical conductance is equal to this formula here. So you can verify that easily on your own if you want to. Anyways, as you can see here, we clearly have a driving force, the voltage change, which I like to think of as pressure in a pipe. It will, air quotes here, force the electrons through, which is obviously a driving force. And on the bottom, we have a resistance. And this represents the resistance to the electron pushing. Think of this like trying to push your electrons through your metal, and you have to compete with a force pushing back on you. And in the electrical analogy, this could be a weaker conductance in your metal, for example. The way I like to think of this is pushing a ball on a flat surface versus pushing a ball on something that's sticky. You may have the same driving force, which is you pushing, but the amount of resistance that you're getting back will be much higher in the sticky floor. So, overall, your rate at which the ball rolls will be subsequently much lower. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding about how the transport analogies relate to electric charges. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.